Hi everyone, good morning. Welcome back to my page. If you're new, thank you so much for joining. Thank you so much for your support. Today's word of encouragement is God says stay in his presence. Don't miss the blessing on your life. God have a blessing for each and one of you, and I want you to know that you don't want to miss it because you didn't stay in the presence of God. A lot of people are missing the blessings that God has on their life. It's something that God want to do with everyone, but we have to stay in his presence. Staying in the presence of God, praying, fasting, meditating, also seeking the Lord. You have to seek the Lord daily. The Bible verse that I want to read is Psalms 37:7, and it reads, "Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Don't worry about evil people who prosper or fret about their wicked schemes." I want to say to everyone, be encouraged. Allow God's will to be done in your life. Do not be discouraged. Always remember that Jesus loves you. Regardless of what's going on in your life, give it to him and let him take care of it. Don't miss your blessing because you wasn't in the presence of God. A lot of people today, they want to do what they want to do, and they think God is going to bless mess. God is not going to bless mess, foolishness. God is going to bless people that is living right. You want to change your life. Live holy. Live the way that God told us to live. You don't believe me? You read your Bible and you see what God says, because God wants everybody to do his will. We have to make sure if we're going to be a Christian, let's be a real Christian. If we're going to live right, let's live right for real. Let's not play no more. Let's not joke about this. Let's make sure that we do everything right, because God don't have time for it. He don't have time for our games. And I just want you to know that if you love God, why you keep playing with him? If you love God, if you take God serious, why you want to keep playing with your life? Take your life serious. God want us to just do his will. We just have to follow what he's saying. All he want us to do is obey. If you obey, if you listen to God, you will eat the good of the land. By you not staying in the presence of God, you're going to miss your blessing. You don't know what your blessing is until you get in the presence of God. Please stay in the presence of God and do not miss your blessing. Your blessing can be singing, dancing, preaching the word of God. It can be going out, blessing people. It can be out, you know, feeding the homeless. It can be anything. It's a blessing on everybody's life. Everybody that's watching me is a blessing on your life. And God want to use each and one of us. And I'm telling you, when you stay in the presence of God, God will use you. You want to stay in his presence. Don't worry about who watching you. Sometimes you can't worry about who watching you. You can't worry about who looking at you. Because when your life change, your friends won't change. That's one thing about God. When God work on you, he not only working on you. He going to work through your friends. He going to work through your family. He going to work through your colleagues. He going to work through people around you. So please, stay in the presence of God and let God continue to work on you and change you. You don't have to be like nobody. I don't care what your friends is doing. They want to have sex. They want to smoke. They want to do what they do. That does not mean that you need to follow them to fit in. Be yourself. Always be yourself. And ask God to show you how to be yourself. You don't have to follow behind your girlfriends. You don't have to follow behind your boyfriends. Ask God to show you who you are in him. That's why when you read your Bible, you stay in the word. God, show me who I am. God, show me who I am. Because some of you, you don't know who you are. You don't know what you want to do with your life. So you don't know what you want to do. You read the Bible and God will show you what you need to do. I want to say be encouraged, stay focused, stay in the presence of God and allow him to work through you. The more you stay in the presence of God, he will show you who you are. He will show you what you're supposed to do. He will take you beyond what you can imagine. And I want you to stay in the presence of God. Don't worry about who watching you. Don't worry about who talking about you, because when God take you to one level to another, people gonna always judge you. Don't worry about who judging you. Don't worry about who talking about you. Don't let nobody words. Don't listen to it. Ignore it. Stay focused on God, because the ones that's laughing at you going to be rejoicing with you. The ones that's putting you down will be the ones that bagging. So I want you to know, stay focused on God. Listen to his voice. Allow God to use you and allow God to work through you. Don't worry about who watching you. Don't worry about who in your way. Remember, Jesus loves you and he loves everyone. And I just want you to know that it's very important to seek him. Seek the Lord daily. Don't worry about who watching you. Don't worry about who talking about you. Stay in his presence. Ignore the voices that you're hearing that's evil, that is bad. Talk to God and allow God to use you, because we all need him as well. You know, I remember when, you know, I've been through a lot in my life as well, but I stayed in the presence of God. I tell anybody, God can change anybody. You know, God changed me. He can change you. He can change anybody. But we don't want to keep living the same way. We want God to change us. We want God to work on us. You don't want to continue to be a sinner. You don't want to continue to steal. You don't want to be just doing anything in this world. You want to make sure you're in the protection of God. You know, anything that you're doing that's out his will, change your life around. You know, you don't want to be, when you know that you're doing things wrong and you know it ain't adding up to God, that's when you know something and you need to change. You need to ask God who you really are, you know. Because you got girlfriends, boyfriends, and you want to be like them. You can't be like your friends. You can't be like everybody. Can't you realize that God said you don't fit in? You're not going to fit in everything in your life. The reason why you don't fit in, because you're not a part of it. That's why he's trying to separate you. Your girlfriend smoking, you smoking, and all of a sudden you choking and you throwing up because that cigarette ain't sitting right in you. So your chest getting congested and you getting these flashes like, why I'm doing this? Because it feel good. It look good. Everything that feel good, it look good, ain't for you. So please get your life together and say, God, get me off this cigarette. God, allow me to wait to merge. God, help me to be a better woman. Help me to be a better man. Show me what you want me to do, and God will show you. You don't have to be like your friends. You don't have to be like your family. You don't have to be like nobody. Be what God called you to be. When you follow God's will, he will bless you. And I promise you, you will have everything that your heart desires. If you want to be married, if you want to have kids, you got to change your life. A lot of you that's watching me, you have to change your life around. God cannot bless you if you're living in sin and you're doing things of the world. You have to change your life. We have to do better to get better from God. You have to change. Something has to go. Something has to leave you in order for God to do something in you. So don't be discouraged. I love you all. Have a great, beautiful day. And thank you for watching. Stay blessed.